Hi guys, so today I'm talking about what I personally think are the top 5 mistakes in Tales of Wind. So, firstly, I think this top 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so the first off, I would say it's the most common one where people are prioritizing getting strong over having fun. Getting strong is nice, but at the end of the day, it's a game and games are meant to have fun. Like, you could have fun without being strong. But sometimes, even if you're strong, you're not having fun. So this is the case of people might argue with their friends because they lost something, or just like they over prioritize building their stats over the social relationships of the game. So yeah, this is power versus having fun. I personally do this a lot, so that's why it is my number one. Number two, I see a lot of free-to-play player, I mean not free-to-play players, low spenders do this so often, it's insane. Pulling without pity insurance. What I mean by pity insurance is you do not have sprouts for delaps. Like, you do not have enough spirals or real money to get what you want without luck. That would just mean you threw all your spending into the trash can without any guarantee. By having the guaranteed, you will be able to get your reward. You will have your reward. But if you just YOLO your dings, you might not get your rewards. Because if you had the pity already saved up, you might get lucky and get it early, then you don't need to spend anymore. You're guaranteed you will save. But if you do it the reverse way, like what I'm saying right here, pity without insurance, you will not get what you want, and you'll be upset. And you won't have fun. So yeah. This one, it's cards over static upgrades. So like, let's say this scenario. Someone with Fire 18 takes Pity's Aeneas talisman card instead of upgrading their accessories, upgrading their mech, etc. Someone who is like, it does not change their gameplay to take a card. And then by the time that they are actually able to clear content, they have all the cards, but their static stats are very behind, such as Dragon Fusion, Polish, let's see, War Mech, and there's quite a few things, but people, you need to make a strong base for your character before you're taking all these cards, which is giving you an upgrade now, but you're gonna replace them by the time you actually need them. Okay, so this one is not something I personally run into. I know people do run into this. So it's scared to ask for help. Like, don't ask me for help, I'm not gonna help you. But, a lot of Tales of Wind players will help you if you ask them. Just not struggler. So yeah, like you could ask Melandra, Shadow Kill, Necco. Like all those people are willing to help people. They all at least help 10 teams a week. Adding one more, I don't really think they care at all. And this one, I feel like a lot of people do this also. Because most mobile game players, I would say, are in their mid-20s to 30s, they're still living with their parents and or so they are keeping probably 100% of their income, 100%. But they are spending 80 to 90% of their income. Like, you really see it a lot in this game. Like, I have a lot of people telling me they make, oh, $2,000 a month. But I see them spending $2,000 worth of spirals in the game. Sometimes even $3,000 worth of spirals each month when they're making $2,000 worth of spirals in a month in real life. It literally does not add up. But yeah, I would say out of all of this is all gameplay. But doing this will affect your livelihood in the real life, in the long run. But yeah, I hope you guys found this video informative. Have a nice day. See you next time.